Hello, Metro4, and I'm back on the Gamemode 4 server. I've been in this river digging sand. Oh, I'm drowning. So, you're wondering, why are you wearing full armor? Well, first you're wondering, why are you still wearing iron armor? Well, we're going to solve that problem in a minute. But your second question might be, why are you wearing armor while you're digging sand? Well, on this server, it's a little dangerous, and I'll show you why. Because I just died. I wasn't wearing armor. Just digging away. And something happened. I don't know if it's going to happen. It's completely random. But there's a chance when you dig, if you have a fortune shovel, which this shovel is amazing. Look, I've got a pickle. If you dig sand under like 4 blocks of water, it'll actually give you like some goodies. If you check my inventory, which you just saw right here, this is some of the goodies you can get, which, oh my gosh, thank you that you can get sponges. Whew, that's nice. And the thing that's dangerous about it, other than forgetting and just drowning, is, ooh, I'm kind of scared. It's only sand, I think, so that dirt didn't count. It's not going to happen when I went to. a guardian can spawn. It's like the chances of it are actually pretty high. And I panic logged a few times trying to despawn it, and it killed me. I've actually died a few times. I've died, what am I, at 7 now? I think 3 of them were on camera. It's been one time I tried out a trident when it was raining. That didn't go so well. The whole landing part's difficult. But this is also something really cool you can get when you're digging sand. It's called a treasure chest. And I wanted to save this one. I've actually opened one up and I got a Heart of the Sea, which is really cool. But I hear you can get some real nice stuff in this one. So I wanted to save this for you. And let's see what we got. Oh my god! See, it's completely random. Once you put it down, if I mine this up, all these items are going to fall out. Whoa! That's not great. 2 diamonds! Oh my lord. Okay, just to prove it, it's not a shulker box. Oh, I don't want to break it. It's a mess. What a mess. But coral, horn coral fan. That's awesome. I kind of don't want a lot of this garbage, but some of this garbage I like. Wet sponge. That's great. 2 diamonds. That's a good get right there. I'll take that clay. Some of that. I'm so full. We'll just prove it. This is not a shulker box or anything. That's awesome. I didn't know that was possible. He can give you a chest that has stuff in it. There you go. It's actually, I can throw it in here. That's not too shabby. We'll just throw all these bottles in. They all have lore, which is kind of cool. It tells a story. I don't want any fish, thank you. Get rid of you, garbage. Okay. I actually barely live in this town anymore. I have a new base. Very fancy, but that's not the point of this. You know what? Let's unstack them all. We're in a spending mood. Here we go. We have the 3 villagers in here. Let's see what we got here. This is how I got my sword and my axe. My hatchet. Who we're looking for, the pickaxe guy. Aha! Yeah, that's who I want. Let's get a full diamond armor. And there we go, awesome. Do I get an achievement for wearing full? I already got the achievement because someone, I picked up someone's pants. Someone put diamond pants on an armor stand and I grabbed it. And I got the achievement, but there we go. My depth sprider. I need to put some depth sprider on this puppy. Not the greatest enchantments in the world. But I can, we can always solve that problem. Thank you. I'm sorry, I'll get off your bed. All right, I've wasted enough time. Let's get to spawn and do that tour. Let's go down to the market right now and check out how much our first machine, our first little shop has actually made us. Because it's been about a week, I think, roughly. And here it is, right down here. It looks a little different from when I first made it. Actually, I'm going to show you this clip right here is going to be my first customer. The machine looks a little different. I've upgraded it. All right, here we go. Oh, we have our first customer. I've been stalking it out, typing in chat, advertising. He's checking it out. Is it going to figure it out? I need to put signs like put diamond in chest. Oh, is he going to do it? Oh, first customer. It worked. Very excited. This guy's my best customer ever. He just bought more. We made like 8 diamonds off that guy. That's awesome. Thank you. I was just slapping a sign down for warranty reasons so I don't get sued. People are buying it already. I'm gonna have to go mine more obsidian, dang it. All right. Gotta grab my new fancy picks and jump into the mine. All right, it's time. Let's jump down there and check this out. I do keep this stocked, so it's not much of a surprise how many diamonds have I made, because I've been mining a lot of obsidian. Trust me on that. Let's go down here, and I'm very excited. Oh my gosh. You see that right there? There's only one thing we can do. There's only literally one thing we can do right now. Ah, much better. Well, we're in business now. The funny thing is, that's not even our only shop. Alright, I cleaned up my mess from my skin change, my closet, my portable closet. Let's go check out our other machine and see how much money we're making. You know what we should do? Let's actually take all the profits. Oh, trust me, there's more profits where that came from. Uh-oh. What did I do with it? We got reserve stone, backup stone. Let's take all this money right here. Oh my gosh. And then we can total it from all the shops and machines and everything and see what our profit so far is. I like that. And the whole thing is, I'm going to do this entire season. I'm not going to touch company profits. I want to gather it all together and see how much profit we've made. Here we go. Here's our next one. Of course, it looks very familiar. But this one's selling packed ice. And it dispenses an entire stack, which is really cool. And I have a block to mine out to jump downstairs. The redstone in this one's definitely a little more complicated. But we got our barrel. And check this out. So this is from the ice right here. Yum, yum, yum. And this is from, I was selling gunpowder for a little bit. And this one's, I was selling some bone blocks. Yeah, there's been a lot of changes. I've been testing the market a little bit. Look at this. Oh my gosh. And tell you what, that's not all my profits. Yep, I know. I'm a great businessman. Magic man, the businessman. I'm going to change my name to businessman now. No, I wouldn't do that. I've been using this name for like over a decade. Here we go. This is it. Oh my gosh, I'm so proud of this. I've been keeping this close, like the store closed. It's not even open yet. And guess what? It's made profits already. People are buying golden carrots left and right. This is actually a really good way to like draw people in. We got more profits. We're just raking in the diamonds. I'm very happy. The whole thing about the shop is I want to give like decent prices. I don't want to rip people off, okay? And let's see, do we have any more profits? We haven't opened yet, and I'm like, hey, how much money are we making? Oh, look at that. There's more money right there. We're selling all kinds of stuff here. There's a whole little like, what do you call that? Like a whole little aisle. What do you call that? It's an aisle. Like a whole like redstone aisle right here, which is really cool. I think someone actually bought something for redstone. If I'm correct. Aha, they bought observers. Money, money. Good, good, good. Even some, ooh, dispensers. Good, good. Did anybody buy any of these? I would actually, this is tempting for me, buying my own comparators. I think that's probably it. Ooh, no, we got some Fortune 3. Very good. Now, is that it? Okay. That's our profits right there. Except for, I think there's one more if we go downstairs. If you see, we have an automated like chest on this one also. But we're going to do like redstone and glowstone. I might change these out because I can change the amounts what I dispense, or I can do single item, which is really cool. We might have like specialty stuff on these two. Oh, and talking about specialty, check this out right here. We have a special offer. One shulker shell, 20 diamonds. You're like, why can't just people go to the end and get it themselves? And you're only selling one of them? Well, here's a clip of me getting it. Remember that shulker that murdered me? My first death on this server? We got a revenge, and we got a shulker shell from it. So check this out. We're up here. I rambled long enough to get up the ladder. We have a silk touch trick. Look at these tools. This bow is amazing. That sword is great. You're not going to stand a chance. So the person that I found this with, they came and saved my stuff. I don't know what we're going to do about sharing this. If I even get one of these shulker shells. Oh, he's ready for me. I might get one if I'm lucky. But on this server, when the end opens, there's such an easy way of getting shulker boxes. It's really not that big of a deal. I'm kind of nervous, actually. Oh, I didn't put the water down. Okay, if I fly in the air, I'm going to put the water right here. Eek! We'll put it right there. I wanted it to do the big one. Do the big one. I'm scared. It's not doing the big thing. Okay, that's fine. I'll just aim for the... I'm going to be over here. I'm totally going to fly in the air and die. Okay, here we go, here we go. Whew. I just need to hit him as fast as possible. Yeah. Oh, he one hit him. I got a shulker. Oh, my God. It's only one, though. Oh, is that it? Is that death? All right, you're trying to trick me, game. I did it. That's awesome. I can't make a shulker box, but one's not very helpful. But I'll have to share it on the weekends with this guy, so... That is awesome. You know what we can do? Take the quick way down, you know what I mean? Ooh. It's always nice to have a looting 3 sword here. Check this out. And since the end's actually not open yet, people are very impatient. They like having backpacks running around the shulker boxes, so they're willing to put out the moolah. So I'm willing to sell it to them, because I have no use for one shulker shell, and trust me, I'm not running around the server looking for another cloud, so I'll take 20 diamonds for that, pup. You know what we should do? I get distracted real easy. Let's go check the profits of the one last little bit of profit here, and then we'll tally up what we've made so far. Because I know we sold some redstone. Awesome. So this is it. This is our final amount. Let's block it up and see our total profits for MVS, Magic Vending Service. That number doesn't look real. We made 54 blocks of diamonds? Are you kidding me? Oh my god. That's more diamonds than I've ever... Literally, in all of my single players, I think that's more diamonds than I've ever had. I'm not sure. It's coming close. Like, in a short amount of time, even. Trust me, we've been working. We've been on the emerald grind to stock this shop up. I am very happy about this. And guess what? I'm not done yet. I'm not done making diamonds yet. We're gonna put the convenience store. We're gonna give these people some good stuff. So what I did, if you saw... I don't know if you saw the corner of the screen there. Let's grab this stuff right here. And we also need one of these puppies. If you saw, there was another machine right outside of this shop. Because I have a plan to do a little fun business on this. Look at this puppy right here. Question mark. Very cool. It looks like it's actually being held up like a real, like, gravity's a thing. That mushroom's actually kind of neat. That's been there for a while. And we're going to chop this down. And we're going to stock this guy with some goodies for one diamond. They're going to have a chance to get a diamond block. I think people are going to take that offer. So we have one diamond block. Let's put it in a weird spot because I don't want people to literally just get it right away. A good diamond sword, a bow, ender chest. See, this is actually... my whole thing is I wanted to give some... Either they're getting a diamond's worth or more. I don't want to rip people off giving them like a piece of dirt or something. Infinity book, depth strider, sharpness 5... Some of these, this is actually a really cool idea I came up with, because I didn't want them to, if they just had bought nine, they could throw 9 diamonds in there and make their money back, and they'll get all this stuff for free. So I wanted to kind of increase the odds, so I make a little profit out of the deal. So this is what I came up with, MBS coupon. So this coupon can be used as payment of one diamond in the MBS shop. So they're still getting their one diamond's worth, so they're not actually losing. They just need to take this, go put it in a chest of something you want to buy. Like, you want to buy 2 stacks of carrots? Put that puppy right there, you grab your 2 stacks of carrots, and I'll count that as a diamond. So, okay, it's raining. The server loves my idea. There we go. So that is now open for business. And we should actually, let's do a little ribbon cutting. I don't know what's going to happen with those, but let's do a little ribbon cutting for our new business and open it up. Here we go. Poof. And we need to, we won't worry about those guys at the moment. That's just some armor stands that someone helped me put there for a little decoration. But we'll get rid of that. And there we go. Our shop is officially open. My shop is officially open. There we go. I'm very excited about this. And let's do a little server tour and then we'll wrap this video up. So how about let's do that. Hello and welcome to my shop. So it's confession time. It's been about a week again. So I was so excited to open up my shop that I may have recorded just that beginning part and then waited about a week. There's been some developments, and I'll clue y'all in. We'll do the server tour a little bit, but I wanted to just show you around my shop a little bit. We've sold many things out of the special offer chest. We sold the shulker shell. We've sold max picks with silk touch and fortune. We've sold an awesome fortune shovel to get treasure. Oh, this has been a great chest. And people, they've been buying so much stuff that I've literally just been restocking, spending my whole time restocking. So we haven't gotten around to restocking this yet. We haven't gotten around to doing game 3 of our random loot, which has been an awesome success, by the way. All like changing what the random stuff they get. I had a diamond block in there in the beginning, and then I changed it to diamond ore, which I think is way better because you're getting a profit, but more people are getting money. So that's been a very big success. We put like coupons in there and people are spending them at our shops. People are buying carrots, golden carrots, which are been flying off the shelves, which are super annoying to get. We're going to have to work out a way to get more of those. Let's actually go downstairs and we'll see the total profits that we've made. No one knows. This is a secret. So you're getting clued in. Only employees are allowed back here. Okay, so you're getting an insight to MVS secrets. Also, you're seeing where I hide the stash. That's where I keep my apples. No one knows this is here. This has been the total profits of MVS throughout all of our businesses, okay? Ready for this? Put in the comments what you thought I was going to have. You thought I was going to have like 10 diamonds. I'm poor as crud. Check this out. That is 96, whatever 96 plus 6 is. 102, nope. 96 blocks times 9 plus, that's a lot of math, but that's a whole lot of diamonds, okay? We actually keep it in our, we have like a little ledger book, which is probably my favorite thing ever. We keep like track of our stock, it's like a stock ledger of how much stuff we got. Oh, and before I get sidetracked, we changed this from glowstone to obsidian. And this auto shop's been very cool. What else did I change? I moved quartz from this shop to somewhere else. You're going to see in a little bit. And let's check out this out right here. This is actually my favorite thing about owning shops in general. The stock. So I have like, this is all of my enchanted books. And if you see here, total profits, 96 blocks and 6 diamonds. Awesome. And we store that puppy safely in here. This is actually, I have 39 ore. 39 diamond ore. That's not too shabby. If I fortuned that, I'd be a generally middle-class wealthy man. All right, let's get out of here. And let's just do that little server tour that I've been talking about that we haven't done yet. The interesting thing is on this server, this whole like middle shopping area that I set up at isn't where it's popping. It's not super populated at the moment. It's kind of moved a little bit, and we moved along with it. I'll actually show you. Remember that packed ice machine that we showed that we're making some good money on? It's gone. We're not here anymore. We had a little bit of a land dispute with one of the owners, so we were like, I'm just going to get out of the whole situation. So we moved that to another shop. We actually have two shops now, not just one. We still have, I'll show you that, but we still have this guy down here. It's making us some steady money. We have 50. How much we got in there? The old barrel. We've made 10 diamonds off that just from just sitting there passively making money. That's pretty nice. We'll come back to collect that later. We just need to keep that thing stocked. Generally, I keep to like 50, and then that lasts me a couple, like maybe a good week. So that's not too shabby. Oh, hello. That actually scared me. Oh, there's like post office now. This is what the mods made to hand out like special trophies for like their Patreon. And I think I might be owed one. I'm not 100% sure. Look at this. This is awesome. Hi, Sparks. Let me check to see if I have anything for you at the moment. I'm sorry. So you're not on the list. Okay, so I already got my trophies from the last month. And then I'll get the Aprils next month. So that's really cool. I thought I'd get a bed, though. There was like a little April Fool's like dragon fight. I didn't get a bed. It was like a trophy. Whatever. Not a big deal. This place is really cool, actually. I like this. Very cool post office. Now let's head... Oh, actually, I want to show also. There's so much things to show in so little time. If we jump down here, and then we keep moving down. So this is the shop we're used to. But there's even another level... This is where the shady people go. And then down here, there's another level. This is where the real shady people go. This is the sewer, literally sewers. And someone built this. One person built this, I think, on the server. It was the head of it, at least. It's very cool. It's like a whole underground black market sewer dungeon. Very neat. And if you join the server, just come check it out. I don't want to run around here. There's a lot of bushes and just little shops everywhere. It's very neat. KFC coming soon. I could eat some chicken. I got pumpkin pie on me right now. Egypt Central. I don't do a whole lot of shopping down here. It's kind of hard to get to. But we're the biggest spot where all the money's been made. I'm in the middle of it. So let's go check that out. We have to go back upstairs. Get out of this overworld and go to the nether. That's right. Oh, hello. That's really loud. We need to go to the nether because someone set up a little temporary nether hub because it's getting reset when the update comes out. It's actually very fancy. So this is what you're used to. I don't even know if you've actually seen this yet, but it's just a temporary little nether hub with an ice path. We're like right down there that goes to our house. And look at this. Red Trading Co. Some very good stuff. We might have to buy one of those totems. Some Wither Skulls. Oh, actually, we got to save that for another episode. I bought some Wither Skulls from like way before the shop was even up. A shopkeeper. Very cool. Guardian Farm stuff. Emerald blocks. Beacons. 32 blocks, or diamonds for a beacon, and look at this. Welcome to MVS. It's basically like the blue version of the red one in town. Free cake! Good deal. This is where I moved the quartz, glowstone, packed ice from that machine. Very cool. And if we come back here, We got some soul sand. If anyone wants to fight they buy the skulls over there. They come over here. They buy the sand. That's how we're working together here. Magma blocks, some overstock on the packed ice there in case someone needs some. I don't know how it got back here, but a pigman was back here. I was gonna name tag it, but I lost it. It despawned on me. Ooh, hello. So this shop has been very nice. Been my main moneymaker is this quartz right here. I've been keeping that restocked day and night. There's a couple shops down here too. This is where it's been popping. The market's been great here. Ein Hollander's Market. Isn't that the guy that owns the redstone shop in town too? He must have moved too. Oh, he's selling one diamond per stack. I got two diamonds. That's why I've been making the money, all right? He's selling enchanted bottles, pumpkins. All right, the shop's pretty good. Silk touch, two diamonds. That's what the market's landed on, two diamonds a book. There was a big crash. Oh, look, it keeps expanding down this way. So when the map when the update comes out, I'm gonna hurry up and rush here and literally just tear down my shop and pack it away before the server resets the Nether and I lose everything. Slimy Honey Iron Shop. Ooh, I don't like that name. What do we got here? 24 blocks per diamond. Okay, iron. Looks like it's coming soon. Very cool. Whoa, I actually haven't seen this one yet. We got rockets up there. This is actually kind of neat. It kind of makes me nervous. We got an invisible armor stand. You get to see this beautiful view of the destruction land. The devastated people devastated it. Sea lanterns, one diamond, three stacks. Ooh, oh, someone else got a guardian farm. Prismarine. I don't really build with guardian farm stuff. We got rockets before. They're making some money. All right. See, I come near. I see someone starting to make some money. I have something I can make. You know, I might start getting into that. One diamond, five. Oh, so they made. Oh, wow. That's actually a lot of rockets they sold them. Two stacks of gunpowder. You know, I'm doing that same deal. It's not a huge moneymaker right now. Maybe I need to turn it all into rockets. All right. There's some good deals here. I'm scouting out the competition. You know what I mean? All right. We still got some open spaces, people to put a shop down. I think that's probably about it. There's some actually really cool builds still in spawn that I haven't seen. A lot of cool pathways. Who do you think sold this packed ice to everybody? Yep, making that money. Alright, so I hope you enjoyed. It's been kind of a shorter episode. I kind of rambled a little bit anyways. But thank you for watching. I'm Magical4. Comment, like, subscribe if you want to. And the server IP is in the description. Come hang out, play, and read the rules! No, I'm just kidding. People are stealing diamonds left and right and getting in trouble on this server. So read the rules when you join and have fun. Come buy stuff from me. Bye.